I'm finally playing the new Geopolitical Simulator. And if I sound pretty tired, that's because it's 2 a.m. for me. I've actually once played the Geopolitical Simulator 4 for a country roulette video, but that's actually 3 years ago, so a very long time ago. And today I just want to look at the different things that have been changed. I've already recorded a German version for this on a German channel, therefore I've already seen a bit. But I also want to show you my first reaction on the English channel. As you can see, we still have the assets from the fourth part, and we have Henry Kissinger. For some reason, a man from third, who had the same accent as former German Chancellor Ludwig Erhard, and it takes like 5 minutes to load, and the game might be crashing, that's not looking good. I think I might have to restart the game. We are 10 minutes in and have finally started. As you can see, we still have the same assets. However, we have much better zooming. We have all of the different ideologies, and where do we have a parliament? We have it over here, and I really enjoy how they've changed it. More flashy and more interesting. We also have a congressman and or senator, and the presidential primaries. Sadly, I don't think the political parties have been changed at all. They are just like they've been before, but there are a few good changes. The first is that we have far more states than we had in the previous entry. We now have multiple states in Cuba, and we have new ones in Belarus, as you can see. We have all of that here. They are obviously fighting Ukraine. Then we finally have a few states in the Philippines. I believe they have 3, and yeah, they have 3. Papua New Guinea, they have 6, including Bougainville, who are going to be independent in real life. Like, I'm not kidding with you. And Papua New Guinea isn't accepting the agreement, maybe, but the vast majority is bought. And I also enjoy looking at the electoral maps. Here we have the US one. In Mexico we don't really have one. In Brazil we also don't have one. But we have the current states, and the ideologies are still pretty cursed. Like, the Social Democrats are socialists, and the socialists are communists, but at least we know of parties. I think we have like 15 or 16 in the Netherlands. In Brazil we also have a massive amount of parties. Let's have a look at India. They don't really have that many. And in Nepal, we of course have a communist democracy. That's a real thing, by the way. And we sadly don't have different states in Bangladesh. I think we only have 2 or 3 in Myanmar. Or Burma, they have only 3. Do they even have any in Laos? I'm not sure. They actually have a few different states. We even have Sikkim in India, who only have how many people in their territory? They have 8 million. That's actually 2 million more than they have in real life. And a really interesting place that used to be independent and then joined India because they didn't want to become part of China. Very impressive temples, actually. Very pretty everything. We can see financial aid for political parties, and here you can see the popularity of Joe Biden, wealth forecast, unemployment, GDP, and of course population. And we have all of the different associations who haven't been changed. By the way, I hope you have enjoyed the video so far. If you did, you should definitely subscribe to your channel, as I'm going to do more videos on this game. And also, if you like to support the video in the algorithm. Here we have the different religions in USA, Muslims, Jews, Buddhists, and Hindus, and most of the options here haven't really been changed, still mostly the same finances, and the different unions. You can also see our budget deficit here, and our GDP, and our unemployment. The game still isn't running very fast, and I actually had to change the resolution at the start of the game. Nepal's boss kinda looked like they are part of India, and here we have the electoral maps again. In India we don't have anything, nothing in Russia, but we have something in Iraq, nothing in Turkey, nothing in Syria, but they only have sham elections anyway. Ukraine, Belarus, and Poland, they also don't have things. But we have an actual electoral map in Austria, and in Germany, and in Italy. The Swiss said they don't have all of the cantons, and of course the French also have their actual parties. In Spain we actually have the same, nothing in Portugal though. Something in the UK at least, and the Canadians. I don't think the governors are realistic though. Like in Kentucky, we don't have a Democrat, and no Republican in Vermont. The final thing I'm going to do today, attack the Mexicans. We need to attack the entire country, and we also need to attack Canada. They have already lost 800 people or 900, and we haven't lost anyone. The dissertations are a new thing, I think, though. And have they been misspelled? And the Canadians also lost 20 people. We still have all of the different disasters, and we can publish a message on Twitter. That's a new thing. Attack the government. No people liking. I can like my own thing, though. Does that change at any point? No, we still only have 0. I think we have gotten kicked out of a bunch of different groups. We got kicked out of NATO. Low troop morale, and we are already falling. I'm accepting my fate. As I said, you don't have a cheating tool. I think there are actually graphics for the war that have been updated a bit. You can see them down here, especially over here. And we have a fatal strike. We are pushing all over the border. Now there won't be any illegal border crossings that aren't even a problem anyway, but now they definitely are the problem. And I am on 0% popularity, Uncle Joe falling, and I've resigned. And with that, we are fallen. I really hope you have enjoyed the video, and I'm waiting on the modding tool to do something, but I really need that one to come out. The same with the cheating tool, as with them we can really do a bunch of interesting stuff. Let's hope that will come out very soon. But I can't really say anything else. Leave a like and subscribe if you've enjoyed the video, and here you can find a different video. There are all 50 US states are trying to conquer Earth, and if you've enjoyed this video, you will definitely enjoy it as well. That's everything I can say for today. In the description you can find my Discord server and the free to join it, but I'm just going to say, bye!